Save. You know, just think about this. I have a grapevine here, a wine bottle. The more I put, will the wine increase or wine decrease? The more I put this wine into one more glass, will the wine increase or decrease? It keeps decreasing. Once you fill it back again, only then it'll be full again. But to many of us, we have been giving and giving and giving. We have forgotten to receive. And what's happening is, the result of it, we are becoming spiritually dry. We are not knowing that we are getting spiritually dry, and we think everything is fine. But one day the dryness comes up and stands before you and say, you cannot do anything. The spiritual dryness comes up and say, you cannot pray. I've seen many people losing interest in reading the Bible. Why? Because the spiritual dryness has taken control of them. They lost interest in praying. They used to pray for 2 hours, 3 hours, 4 hours, fasting prayers, half night prayers, full night prayers. But all of a sudden they lost interest in prayer. The person who is coming to church every Sunday, every Friday, every Saturday, but all of a sudden he's not seen in the church. Why? What happened? The spiritual dryness stood before him because he was only giving and giving and giving. He had forgotten to receive. And that is why God says, disciples, receive the Holy Spirit. Receive the Holy Spirit. You need to receive the word of God. You need to receive the prayer from God. You need to receive His presence. You need to receive His mercy. You need to receive His grace. We have forgotten to receive. That is why we become spiritually dry. You know, how do you understand whether you're spiritually dry or not? You keep seeing, instead of moving from faith to faith, you keep going from faith to unbelief. That is the symptoms that you are going spiritually dry. You used to pray for 10 minutes with all enthusiasm, but your enthusiasm is coming down. That is a sign, it's a symptom that you are getting spiritually dry. Let me tell you this, in a Christian life, everyone will go through the spiritual dryness because we have forgotten to receive. I have only been giving and giving and giving and giving and giving and giving, and then afterwards God spoke to me, you are only giving, you are not receiving. And I got spiritually dried up. And that's when God said, you need the refilling, the refueling, re-anointing. You need that revival in God. You know, only when God spoke to me, the revival came back. Only when God spoke to me, the refueling and the refilling came up. And I want to tell you this morning, if you're spiritually dry, that means you've been only giving and giving and giving. As a Christian, when we are baptized, we say, yes, I need to give, I give, I give, I give. But you've forgotten to receive. Let me tell you this. Spiritual dryness can take you from God. He can take you far away from God. Even before you could know, you are away from God. So let me tell you this. Every day, every week, examine yourself. Am I getting spiritually dried up? If I'm getting dried up, I need to refuel myself. I need to refill myself. There are many times we go through restlessness from inside. Everything is fine. You have a good job, nice income, family is good, your wife is good, your friends are good. Everything is good, but something inside which says you are restless. You're restless from inside. You do not know what is irritating you, what is frustrating you. You do not know what is disturbing you, but there's something restless inside. You cannot share this to your wife. You cannot share that to your husband. You cannot share that to your children. You cannot share that to your parents. You cannot share that to any of them. You're only struggling. You're feeling restless inside. Has anyone gone through that? Don't put your hands up. You all have gone through that. We feel restless somewhere deep inside. We are restless. We do not know whom to contact. You do not know whom to speak to. You do not know whom to say something. You are restless inside. What's happened? The problem is you have lost your communication with God. You have lost that relationship with God. That is a sign which says you are restless. You know, you are restless. Your spiritual man should not be dried up. Let me tell you this. The Bible clearly says, when an evil spirit leaves a man, the Bible says, when the evil spirit leaves a man, it goes outside. It looks for a watery places. Even the evil spirit is looking for watery places. It doesn't want dry places. Let me tell you this. The evil spirit is looking for a place that is neatly put, and it is fully where there's water. You're with me this morning? Your soul is looking for a place that is watered, not a dry place. Your spirit is looking for a place that is watered, not a dry place. If your spiritual life is dried up, your soul is looking for something else. That is where people are looking for addictions. People are looking for love. Instead of filling the place with the water, you know what they're doing? They're looking for something else. Right in the book of Genesis, the Spirit of God was hovering over the water. Did you see that? The Spirit of God was hovering over the water. It is not in the dry places. Not in the dry places. No one likes to go to dry place. No one likes to go be there in the dry place. No one likes to be in desert for more than 5 minutes or 10 minutes. Why? Because it's a dry place. And people are not liking to come to you because you have become dried. You've dried up. Your spiritual life has dried up. And you lost that relationship with God. And now all you're doing is trying to act. Trying to live what you are not. And this morning, we need to understand that I need to be refueled and refilled. And I don't want to be in a dry place. Let me tell you this. Elijah, after the success, he had to go through a dry place. After all the success, you know what happened? He ran inside the cave. And God knew where Elijah was. He said, Elijah, what are you doing here? What are you doing here? Because Elijah was only been giving and giving and giving and giving. He forgot to receive. That is where God spoke to him. And he came back again more powerfully. Let me tell you this. The more you become dry, the more you're getting away from God. So this morning, let us make a decision that I will not be in a dry place. My spiritual life, I will not allow my life to be get dried up. Let me tell you this. If you put a plant, if you put a seed in the sand, on the soil, what do you do afterwards? You water it. If you forget to water one day, what does it happen? The leaves will get dried up. The plant gets dried up. If you don't water it for second day, it gets more dried up. Third day, fourth day, and it dies. Why? A seed or a plant needs water. You need water. You need the presence of God. You need the anointing of God. And many of us, instead of being watered, we are running away to dry places. That is why in Psalm 23, we'll all open our Bibles to Psalm 23. The verse which says, He leads me beside the still waters. Come on, we all know this passage. You opened it? Psalm 23, is everyone on that page? Since we all know this, we want to read together. The Lord is my shepherd. You can tell it behind me. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I lack. He lets me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He renews my life. He leads me along the right paths for His name's sake. Even when I go through the darkest valley, I fear no danger, for You are with me. Your rod and Your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Only goodness and faithful love will pursue me all the days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord as long as I live. He lets me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He doesn't want to take you to dry places. Yes, there are times when He takes you to dry places. But He doesn't want to keep you in the dry place. Your spiritual dryness can affect your physical life as well. We have forgotten that we are both physical and spiritual. Let me tell you this again. You have forgotten that you are both physical and spiritual. You're only thinking about your physical life. I'm taking bath every day. I'm drinking water. I've been properly in the watery places. But God says it's not just your physical life that needs to be watered. Even your spiritual life needs to be watered. And we're forgetting about it. And that's why the Bible says, He leads me beside quiet waters. He renews my life. Only when He takes you through the quiet waters, He renews your life. Amen? He will renew your life. It's not people. We all know all those people have license. You have to renew your license after a few years. You have to renew your life. He is the one who renews our life. Let's open our Bible to Psalm chapter 42 verse 5. Psalm 42 verse 5. It says, Why art thou cast down, soul? And why art thou disquieted in me? Hope thou in God, for I shall yet praise Him for the help of His countenance. Look what Psalmist David says. Psalmist David says, Oh, why? This version is really good. Why am I so depressed? You're with me? Why am I so depressed? Have you ever thought, why am I so depressed? Have you ever got depressed? Yes or no? Yes, we get depressed. Psalmist David says, Oh soul, why are you depressed? Why this turmoil within me? Why this problem within me? And look at the next word. It says, Put your hope in God. Whom is he saying? Not to others. He's telling to himself. He's telling to his soul, Oh soul, why are you depressed? Have you ever spoken to your soul? Have you ever spoken to yourself and saying, Why am I depressed? Why are you so depressed? We don't have time to speak to ourselves. You know, in 2020, make sure you give time for yourself. That's the greatest gift that you can give to yourself. Give your time to yourself. Give time to yourself. We have time for family. We have time for society. We have time for church. We have time for others. We have time for everything. But there's no time for me to examine myself whether I am depressed or not. You don't have time for that. You're only thinking about my mother, my father, my brother, my sister, my church, my church brother. You're only thinking about your job. You're thinking about the society. You're thinking about Modi. You're thinking about CAB. You're thinking about NRC. You're thinking about MPC. All C's you're thinking, and you're not seeing yourself. Let me tell you this. It's time to give some time for yourself. In 2020, make sure before, if I am not growing, I don't think I cannot allow others also to grow. If I'm not growing, if I'm not watered properly, I will not allow others also to grow. You know, the problem with the thorny bushes is that they don't allow other plants to grow. They have thorns all around them. They don't allow other plants to grow. Why? Because they are thorny. They don't want others to grow. Why? Because they're already depressed inside. There's already some turmoil inside. See, Psalmist David says, look what a wonderful way he speaks to himself, not to you, not to me. He says, Oh soul, why are you so depressed? I don't understand why you're so depressed. Why are you in so turmoil? Put hope in your God. The moment you put hope in your God, you are watered. Because for those who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagle. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Let me tell you this. For those who wait on the Lord, they keep walking and walking. I said this in the fasting prayer. They keep walking and walking and walking, walking and walking and walking, but still they're not getting weary. Amen. For those who hope in the Lord, they keep running. You know, it's very hard to run. Have you ever tried to run? For all those people who have big tummies, know this. I struggle. To run, it's difficult. Oh, to run for 2 minutes. We get off. Oh my God, I'm done. I'm tired. What's happening? You're not able to run. But the Bible says, for those who hope in the Lord, for those who wait in the Lord, they run and run and run and not run, and still they not be weary. They'll walk and walk and walk. They'll still not be faint. Hallelujah. In 2020, you need to keep walking and walking and walking. But it's not faint. For that, you need to tell your soul, Oh soul, don't be depressed. Don't be in turmoil. Put hope in God, because it is He who is going to lead you. Hallelujah. If you're spiritually dry, it's time to put hope in God. Put hope in God and say, Yes, my soul is depressed. Yes, my soul is in turmoil, but still I will trust in God. You know, what was the problem of David? How many problems did he have? Just see through his life. Everywhere he had problem. There is not even one place where he could say, Yes, thank God I could sit now. The moment he got anointed, from that time onwards he had a problem with Saul. He killed Goliath. From that time, he had problem with Saul. He got married to Michal. He had a problem with his father-in-law. And afterwards, he moved forward. He had problem with his army. He had problem with Philistines. He had problem with his own son. Everywhere, he's having only problem after problem. You know, definitely I can tell you, he was more depressed than you and me. That is why he's saying, oh soul, don't be depressed. He was encouraging himself. I will tell you this important principle. Please keep this in your mind. No one will come and encourage you. No one will come and encourage you. It is you have to encourage yourself. Oh soul, don't get depressed. Don't get into turmoil. Put trust in God, because he is the only one who can lead you forward. No human can lead you. Hallelujah. Make sure in 2020, don't put your trust in man. Put your trust in God, because he will lead you. You will walk and walk and walk, but still you will not faint. You will run and run and run, but still not be weary. And that is what God wants in our lives. He says, oh soul, don't be depressed. Oh soul, don't be in turmoil. Put your hope in God, for I will still praise him, my Savior and my God. See, look at this verse. He says, even though I'm depressed, I'm still praising God. Even though I'm in turmoil, I'll still praise in God. Can you say these words? Even though you're depressed, can you say, I still praise in God, for he is my Savior and my God. Can you say these words and say, Lord, I believe in you, Lord. You're the only one who can lead me. I still praise you. Your spiritual dryness maybe is taking over you. It's time to tell, I put my hope in God. I'll still praise in God. You know what? I'll tell you this important principle. Your praise and worship actually waters your soul. Your praise and worship actually waters your soul. That is why David always wanted to go and praise God. Daily, 7 times he used to go and praise God. Why? Because he understood, my soul gets watered up only when I praise God, when I worship God. Today, many of us are giving less time to praise and worship. Why? Because we are not thinking about a spiritual thing. Let's all open our Bibles to Job chapter 14, verse 8. Job chapter 14, verse 8. Though the root thereof wax old in the earth, and the stalk thereof die in the ground, yet through the scent of water it will bud and bring forth boughs like a plant. Look at this. Though the root thereof wax old, though if its roots grow old in the ground and its stump starts to die in the soil, verse 9, yet through the scent of water it will bud. The smell of water makes it thrive and produce twigs like a sapling. You might be old. Your roots might be getting old. Your roots might get wax old. Your stalk might be dying in the ground, but the scent of the water, look at this, not even water, the scent of the water will spring it up, it seems. Hallelujah. This morning, make a decision. My life might be spiritually dry. It might be in the dying stage. I'll make sure that I'll water. No matter what Satan tells you are fit for nothing. You cannot praise God. You cannot worship God. You're wax old in your spiritual life. Your spiritual life is gone. Let me tell you, even if you are at the verge of dying, God has the power to raise you up, because he is the resurrection and the life. Even though your spiritual life might be dead, he can raise you up. It's you have to believe. You have to water it and say, my spiritual life, my soul, you might be tired. You might be depressed. You might be in turmoil, but still I will water it. Amen. Make a decision that you will water your soul every day. Water your spirit every day. Your spiritual dryness is putting you in depression. Your spiritual dryness is putting you in turmoil. Your spiritual dryness, let me tell you this, the turmoil is not with others. There's a turmoil within you. A turmoil with others can be solved. Let me tell you this. If you have a problem with others, it can still be solved. You can still let go of it. But a turmoil within you is the most dangerous thing. Have you ever seen that? If there's a war between you, you cannot sustain. You cannot live. You cannot sleep. You know, all those people who cannot sleep, all those people who have sleepless nights, it's because you have a turmoil within you. You're thinking, I'm thinking. There's a war between you, a war which is not allowing you to sleep. Why? Because you're still not hoping in God. Still not trusting in God. It's time to trust God and say, Lord, I believe in you, Lord. Yes, there's a war between, war in me. There's a turmoil in me. And I believe that you are going to set me free. Look at this verse. The scent of the water, the scent of the water will spring up, the root be a sapling. It again regenerates. There's some revival happening. Have you ever seen a tree? How do you plant a tree? There are some trees, if you can just take a little branch out of it and put it, it becomes a tree again. Have you ever seen that? A small branch. The tree might be dying, but out of the tree, you take one small thing, you put it, it becomes a new tree. And God says, that is how you are. You are a tree planted beside the still waters. Even though Satan is trying to kill that root, God is saying, out of you, one branch will come, and that branch will become a tree. Hallelujah. So this year, don't settle for little. Don't settle for something what Satan is putting before you. I want to tell you, there's many Christians. I'm not hurting anyone. There are many Christians like dogs. A small biscuit, you run behind that biscuit. Let me tell you this. Don't be like those dogs, just running behind a small biscuit. Make sure that you are a human being. You are going to stand firm for the truth. You're going to say, no matter what happens, whoever puts biscuit for me, whoever is going to put some small promotions for me, Satan is going to say, I'm going to put a great promotion for you. Don't listen to it. Why? Because God is the one who's going to promote you. I said this and I love this verse. What God has opened, no man can close it. And what God has closed it. Hallelujah. So don't try to find your own doors. Find the door of life, the Jesus. He will open the door. Once you open the door, not even your boss, not even your the CEO, no one can stop you from being a promoted person. Hallelujah. But we are still looking towards the worldly things. The Bible clearly says the scent of the water. Today, if you're thinking you're dying from inside, it's time to restart your life. In the first week of the year 2020, restart your life and say, no matter what Satan is trying to do to you, no matter what Satan is trying to plan for you, you say, no, Satan, you have a plan, but my God has a plan which is higher than all the plans. He has a thought that are higher than all the thoughts, and I am going to be prosperous, and I'm going to be blessing. I'm going to see breakthroughs in my life. I'm going to see revival in my life. Why? Because I have a God who can change things upside down. Hallelujah. Yeah. In 2020, don't settle for little. Restart. It might have targeted your root. Now out of the branch, take it and plant it one more. Start sowing. How many of you want to reap harvest by the December 31st, 2020? You want to reap? You want to reap harvest? How many of you want to reap harvest? Without sowing, you cannot reap. A simple principle. We are trying to reap where we have not sown. That is the problem with us. In 2020, in the rest, I would say, the first 6 months, start sowing. Keep sowing. Keep sowing everywhere, wherever God has allowed you to sow. Sow your life, sow your talent, sow your energy, sow your time in the presence of God. By the end of December, you will reap. You know what's happening is we are trying to reap on December 31st. And what is coming? You know, if you leave a land empty, for 6 months, what happens? What happens? The thorns come. The unwanted plants come. Unwanted things. There's no fruit in it. Even though there's a fruit, you cannot use that fruit. Unwanted plants give unwanted fruits. You're leaving your land empty the whole 6 months, and by the end of December, you're expecting a harvest. How is that possible? You have not sowed in the year and you're expecting harvest. Let me tell you this. A farmer always sows and he reaps. He sows and he doesn't say, last year I put cotton. This year also cotton should come. Can it come? No. He's already reaped it. Now it's time for him to sow again. He sowed wheat last year, and he says, okay, last year anyone sowed wheat, now this year it has to come automatically. Can it come? And by the way, it's not Facebook formula. You know, all those people who played Facebook formula, you know this. You put a seed and it comes after 2 hours, 3 hours, you harvest it, and there's nothing, no hard work. That is not how it is. You sow and you reap. You sow and you reap. In this year, in 2020, in the first part of your life, start sowing. I would say every day keep sowing. Keep sowing. Everywhere you go, you keep sowing. Keep sowing your talent, time, energy. You know what farmer does? He sows and he doesn't think about the harvest. He only keeps thinking about sowing. How can I make sure that the plant grows? He keeps watering. Every day he keeps watering. Every day, if you see a farmer, he gets up in the morning at 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock. He goes to the farm. He sows the manure. He puts the water. And again, he goes back home. He comes back again in the afternoon. Again, he waters. Again, in the evening, he comes back. Again, he waters. He makes sure that there's no weeds coming up. He makes sure that everything goes fine. All those people who are done farming know this. He makes sure that the field is protected. Every day he keeps sowing. Every day he takes care of it. And this year, if you really want to harvest something, make sure that your land is not dry. Water it properly. Make sure your soul is not dry. There might be depression. There might be turmoil. But still, you tell to your soul, oh soul, hope in God, because He is your Savior and He is my God. He is the one who can take you further. You keep walking and you will not get weary. You will run and not faint. It's time for us as a Christians to trust in God. We'll see one more verse from 2 Corinthians chapter 4 verse 16. 2 Corinthians chapter 4 verse 16. For which cause we faint not, but though our outward man perishes, yet the inward man is renewed day by day. Look at this. What a wonderful. Therefore, we do not give up. How many of you have given up? How many of you gave up? You are with me this morning. How many of you gave up on things? How many of you gave up on promises of God? How many of you gave up on what God has spoken to you? Bible says, therefore we do not give up. Don't give up. Whatever God has promised, don't give up. Whatever He has promised, don't give up. He says, therefore we do not give up. Even though our outer person is being destroyed. Look at the verse that says, word that says, your outer person is destroyed, but the inner man is renewed day by day. When is your man renewing? Inner man getting renewed? Not weekly. Not on Sunday. Not on first Sunday, not on once in a month, not once in a year. Your inner man is renewed day by day. When is your inner man being renewed? When is your inner man being renewed? No, when? When you don't give up. It says, therefore we do not give up. Therefore we do not give up. Therefore we do not give up. Why? Because my inner man is being renewed day by day. Don't give up. Don't give up on your spiritual life. Don't give up on your prayer life. Don't give up on your Bible meditation. Don't give up in relationship with God. If your relationship is broken, there is spiritual dryness. If there is spiritual dryness, listen to this. Even the evil spirit doesn't want to come to you. And the evil spirit doesn't want to come to you. How will the Holy Spirit come to you? Let me tell you this. All the watery places are being dried up by the evil spirit. It leaves you fit for nothing and goes away. That's what the evil spirit does. All the watery places, it drags it out. It makes you as a dry person. It makes you as almost like a dead person. And then goes away because it knows once this person is dry, once is depressed, once is turmoil, you will not come out of it. That is what evil spirits are doing. Every evil spirit is only planning to dry that water that is there in you and make you a dry person. Everywhere you go, you have a sad face. What happened? Nothing happened. I'm like this. Why there's no joy in you? There's no joy. I've lost joy 10 years ago. Why there is no smile on you? I lost my smile. You know, some people say, when my father died, he took my smile also away. When my wife died, she took my happiness also. She took my joy. There's some people who say this. And God says, no. Satan, evil spirit, is trying to dry you up. And it wants to be dry. It wants you to be dry. But you say, no, I will not let my soul to be dry. In 2020, don't give up on the promise that God has given. Whatever promise God has given, hold on to it. And say, Lord, I will move forward. The outer man might be getting destroyed, but the inner man is renewed day by day by the promise of God. The inner man is renewed day by day by the hope that I have in God. The inner man is renewed day by day by not giving up. Hallelujah. Don't give up. Don't give up in 2020, no matter what happens, don't give up. Because that is where you'll have the renewal. Or else, you're not better than a dead man. You're equal to dead man. Once your spirit gets dried up, you are equal to a dead man, because you're not able to speak to God. You're not able to see miracles. You're not able to pray. You're not able to see any supernatural things in your life. You're like a dead man doing nothing. Because the Bible says, for one who believes, these things follow. What are those things follow? You speak new tongues. You proclaim healing. Healing happens. You proclaim deliverance. Deliverance happens. When you say evil spirit run, they'll be here. The evil spirit running away. Why? Because a living man can proclaim all this thing, but a dead man cannot do all this thing. The evil spirits, Satan's goal is only one thing in 2020 for you. It wants to make you dry, spiritually dry. But you tell, yes, I'm depressed. My soul is depressed. Oh soul, why are you depressed? Oh soul, why are you in turmoil? Don't give up. Don't give up on God. I still hope in God, because He is my Savior and my God. Let me tell you this. In 2020, we do not know what is there for us. What is in store for us, we do not know. What is there, what's going to happen in February, no one knows. What's going to happen in August, no one knows. What's going to happen in December, no one knows. But one thing you know, that all these days and months and years are held by God, and He can take care of your life. Hallelujah. Go with one hope. Do not give up on God. Do not give up on God, no matter what happens. People might say, I'm going to kill you, but still go with a hope. My God is going to take care. My God is going to lead me till the end of 2020. If He wants to take me back, I'll still be happy. I'll still be happy, because if God wants to take me, I'll be there with Him, not with the world. Hallelujah. Let's make sure that we will not give up on our promises. Make sure that your soul and your spirit doesn't dry up. Don't allow the spiritual dryness to affect you. Yes, you might go through struggles. Yes, you might go through dryness. But still tell your soul, oh soul, don't be depressed. Oh soul, don't be in turmoil. Hope in God. I'm telling you, you are the only one who have to encourage yourself. Keep telling your soul, oh soul, don't get discouraged. Don't give up on the promises of God. Don't give up on what God has given to you. Don't give up on all the prophecies that God has given. Whatever He has given, hold on to it. Do not give up. Let's all close up.